male, 16. Criminal mischief, vandalism, 2 counts. Resisting arrest, assault on the officer, probation violation.
You know him.
DHR, Harris number 5. Female, 15, apprehended in process of burglary of a habitation. Complaint pending assault, probation violation, 2 prior convictions, parent notification exempt.
Can I hold my glasses?
Unsuccessful. Mom, Andy.
I'm doing Zoom.
Also known as Andy, male, 15, communicating gambling information, specifically delivery of bookmaking and numbers receipts. 5 previous arrests with varying charges, all dismissed on basis of incompetency. Remanded to Department of Human Resources 5 times. Guardian notified. Sanderson, Jeffrey, also known as Skip, male, 16. Driving under the influence, 2nd offense. Driving without license, resisting arrest, probation violation. Parent notification attempt, unsuccessful. Miller, Karen, female, 16. Leaving the scene of an accident, hit and run. Parents notified.
She bowed it.
Grimes, Liam, female, 15, kidnapping, parents notified. Balloon, Anne, Elizabeth.
No, it is not balloon, it is balloon. I hate it when people do that.
Whatever, female, 14, over $200 and under $2,000, specifically shoplifting, parents notified. Jane, arrest number 773, female, approximate age 14, investigation of runaway, resisting arrest, refused to give name, address, parent's name, or location, Department of Human Resources notified, parents unknown, Collins, Mark, also known as Sonny, male, 17, investigation of aggravated assault and unlawful right to avoid prosecution. Action pending verified information, Woodson PD. Charlotte, also known as Pinky, alias Charlotte Singleton, and C.J. Simpkins, female, 16, delivery of a controlled substance, possession of controlled substance, carrying prohibited weapons, unlawful fight to avoid prosecution, resisting arrest, probation violation, 5 prior convictions, parents refuse to appear, probation officer notified.
Jeffrey Dahmer.
All right, roll call, count up. Now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. All right, wait a minute, there's something wrong. It's supposed to be 12, count up again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Somebody's getting locked down. Count up again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. What, you think he's one? Some kind of gang of
crazy? Hit him with a stick.
Bet you won't hit it.
You are locked down.
Send my wenches up there. Y'all making my wench cry. Stop that.
Papers in them. If I don't deliver them, they'll fire me. I don't want to get fired.
find a job.
No.
I got my presents, I can't get fired.
Maybe you could get a job in a 7.
Call me then.
That's awesome now.
Y'all ain't gonna fire.
What's it to you?
Got him enough.
So who are you? Donnie the Bed? Oh, no.
I'm
play among it all. They could run on the sand and chase each other on the surf like dolphins.
Face. Man, that guy was screaming and shaking, but he couldn't see. Then Hank grabbed my bottle and he hit him on the head.
Man,
he dropped. He wasn't moving.
The bottle.
And then he just stood there, shaking his head from side to side, just shaking his head. So he grabbed me and we ran to the park.
What's the two?
He sideswiped the car from into the lot. And I could see it was the kids from the park. Man, Hank saw them too. And he started twitching like he was having a fit.
Don't know who did it.
Man, I didn't do anything.
You with me, aren't you? You gotta get out of here.
I didn't know what to do. I was scared. So we stayed on the back roads and avoided the intersection.
Once we get into the city, we was fading into the crowd.
We got to the city about sunrise. And Hank got even crazier. His eyes kept darting everywhere and he started twitching again. Then he saw a cop parked by the curb and he just went nuts. He took off about 80 miles an hour. Man, that cop didn't even see him. But he called in the rest of the cops in the world. And we were running lights and taking corners at 50 miles an hour. And I kept screaming, "Hey man, stop the car!" But he wouldn't. Then he shirt up the lamppost and he go right down the alley. He thought he could make it between the truck and the wall. But at the last second, he panicked and tried to stop. The car skidded sideways into the truck. Hank side first. I guess I'm back.
Hanging out with losers, scratching for some boyfriend stuff. He got lug boots at the gym.
And burglary. And I done some time. And there was nothing but more of the same face.
That's what
I figured if I was gonna take a fall, it might as well be worth it. So I'm just the magic. Then all those empty outsiders will come to me on my terms. Whatever I wanted, they came to me. And me, backing off the best. No shot. If one cross man undercut me, he might not get his for a while. I could wade that and make him think he slipped deeper. You ought to see him when they come back past you, saying it wasn't enough. So maybe somebody catches you at it. Kind of stuff. What are they gonna do? Call a cop? If they kick you just back off and say, hey, mistakes happen. Here's something better on the house. And slip him maybe 3 times to strike his head. I stumble a little more strict now and then than usual. You won't have that problem.
Need a rubber band. Let's go, blow. Yeah.
and I spread the gasoline near inside walls, or by cloth, or by drapes.
Sean, you promised me you'd try it. What's going on with
this? The scratches on it. No, don't look for them. Nobody dealing with a knife or a nail, but they're there.
Scratches?
Old lady says.
Get busy on your homework or no TV.
Scratch. Old man.
Why don't you get this boy some instead of just sitting around my house?
Scratch. The coach.
Oh, you gonna run that slow? Take another lap.
Scratch. Some teacher.
Or I'll fit the state capitals by Friday.
Scratch. The preacher.
Thou shalt not get that.
Scratch.
Mm-hmm. I always watch it a while, but then it's not enough. You toss in the gasoline, and up it goes. And then you run and find some place where you can watch it all.
States, capitals, left, everyone carving their initials in me. So I carve my initials someplace. A table, a desk, or maybe someone else's initials, so they can catch the heat.
But what did it get you?
Even. The school building started looking pretty good at night. And I tell my mother to go to practice and watch my old man drill all over himself. Instead, I go to school and decorate just a little. It looked pretty good the next morning, stretched up the way I am.
Huh?
Are you gonna stretch too?
No, sorry, go on.
But it didn't stop.
You want a driver's license? Better learn some responsibility.
We all made the money, you have to get a job. It's time for tough.
Tough, huh? Try from this angle.
I like him to catch slowly at first so I can watch it all. The first bit of flame show up on the outside, licking the sides of the building. Or maybe it'll shoot through a window and go screaming towards the sky. And like there's plenty of light, I don't have to fight the darkness anymore. Or like I could go to sleep without worrying about something coming and getting me. Or someone.
So I scratch some more. Nobody can drive the car.
Still scratch.
If the tires are slashed, chain links cut real easy. In the dark, and driveways get spray painted. Unexpected. So everybody gets it. Sometimes I'm out at 2, maybe 3 in the morning, take a nail, drive it out every car for about 5 or 6 blocks. Pretty soon, everybody will be scratched. Just like I am. And maybe they'll stop once they get enough of their own.
Have you ever seen a really big fire? It's like noontime in the light of the moon. Like a big noontime sun you made yourself to kill the darkness. I stare so hard into it sometimes, I see myself looking back up, calling myself into the brightest part. It's warm in there, and it never gets dark. Never.
Dark.
Arrest number 773, now identify as James Philip, female, 15, arson, guilty. Remanded to Children's Psychiatric Center. Sentencing pending.
You know what? I don't even know why you've been here.
look at your sorry behind.
If that's how you feel, then just leave. It ain't like I asked you to come.
You know what? I'm through with you. I'm so sick and tired of always getting into trouble. Now, when you need somebody to be there for you, don't come looking for me.
Don't worry, I won't.
Wait. Look, Sean. It just hurts me to see you like this. You don't belong here.
I
want
to come home. I don't like it here. I don't even like the people here.
I know, but this is all the best. Next time, you won't do the things that you did because you know better.
I want to come home.
There's nothing I can do for you. Just gonna have to come out. You know, Sean, I forgive you for what you've done. But I can't forget about it.
Mama, I'm sorry if I hurt you. And I promise when I get up, I promise I'll be a better person.
I know you will.
Time's almost up.
You know I love you, right?
Yeah, I know.
All right. All right, that's good.
You know what I mean? Strap down! Strap!
He's got to take
it.
Baby, dog.
mind how much I missed her. Jenny needed me. I could tell when I was reading to her or feeding her her bottle that she loved me better than anybody. Nobody else felt like that about me. So I wanted to meet her more and more. We got to have a long day conversation. And all night my words about how she was up there would treat her right. Babysitter. They couldn't see how much more I was. Jenny wanted me with her, but they didn't try to see. I told them they wouldn't have to pay me or anything. Just let me take care of her. Let me be with her. But they kept her from me even more. I listened on the phone when they told Mom I couldn't take care of Jenny anymore. I had to bury the phone under my pillow and cry. But that time, it all came at once.
Who's baby bottle?
You know how I usually cry after you build up to it? Deep breathe or sigh? But that time, it all came at once. I didn't stop for hours. I just walked. I didn't have any friends at school or dates or anything. I didn't need any of that. If I had Jenny, and she needed me. Then I found out they were having a dinner on Friday night. A girl I knew to the house and told her that Jenny Foles wanted me to bring her to them. She said she had to call them, and I said okay. But as soon as she left, I grabbed Jenny and ran out. I started driving. It didn't matter where we went, so long as Jenny was with me. Jenny was so good. She slept all the way. And finally, I had to stop. I couldn't draw against me. I fell asleep when I woke up, the sun was streaming in the windshield. And the highway patrolman was tapping on the glass.
He left her.
They took her from me again.
Take it to Jerry Spring.
He didn't understand how much she needed me. He didn't understand. I ran. I saw a cop, and I was so scared that I didn't try to build.
But it's okay. Yeah, look at that.
But by the song, I don't play. Nah. Thank you, all the songs.
Boom! We're rolling on more leaks.
Is she dead? Shut up, will you? I about you, you lost all those creeps. What difference does it make anyway? We lost it the same story. We had to get rid of the meaning and effect like that, got it?
They won't buy that.
They wouldn't have said it hard enough, then it won't be a lie. Have you got that?
Yeah, dang. Got it.
Good.
Oh.
What if she's dead? What about... Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. What if she's dead?
What if she's dead?
What if somebody's
gone? Just tell her. Say, why is she not?
And bless you for the diamond. What if somebody talks? What if they say it was not me? It wasn't not just me. It was... Holy Mary, Mother of God, I just swing first, it was self-defense! And we all stopped her. Pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our...
Heck now, Mom! You got it too! You figured if you kept quiet long enough, they just wrap you up and drop you on Mr. and Mrs. America's doorstep. And the first thing you know, you're on the cover of this Teen Queen magazine, huh? Well, it's not that simple. Because if I don't know where to put you, I just put you any place. Any place that's exactly like home, except for the bars on the windows and the locks on the doors and your new circle of friends. Understanding this girl's hesitation.
Swamp.
You belong under
two points, babe.
I've been to several of those homes, and sister, you all right. There are always some girls who've been there a long time, and your girls look like just what they had in mind.
Just stop.
Shut up! Because this girl like mine don't think the girl can throw a call or anything. They might have someone do it for them. Of course, you can say no, but it's amazing how many friends they have and how persuasive they can be. So there's your choice. A slave, I have to get on a plane maybe twice a day. So you become her personal property. And she'll take care of you, yeah, so long as you take care of her and anybody else she decides to have you take care of. But you'll be perfectly safe until one day she wants to lift the guard down somebody else's head. And then she might have to negotiate a trade. And you are it. So you got a new big sister, and the process goes on until you're a big sister yourself, if you live that long. Yeah, girl, keep your mouth shut. And remember to impart a sign for yourself. There's no place like home.
Shut up!
Key under the doormat of the mailbox. You could tell it was something old. God's place. Old books and pipes. Everything dusty. He lived a lawless scene. But I wasn't worried about him. I had to get at least $100 for his defense. I could make my connection and I needed his TV. It was too big. Black and white anyway. Those people never have stereos. There wasn't much in the back either. But I knew that people that age kept money hidden somewhere. Depression or something made them that way. I started digging through his shoes. There sometimes when I heard someone coming.
I ducked in the closet.
I stopped breathing. I heard him touch the doorknob.
Who's there?
I slammed against the closet door. When I turned to get up, he was over the corner.
You are a girl.
What do you want? I was just trying to keep warm. It wasn't happening.
Get up.
I saw a cane in the corner. I grabbed it and smashed it. A lighter!
She might have shot
it. He hasn't come to me with the lighter. Okay, where is it? I know it's in someplace.
Why are you doing this?
Just give me the money and I'll leave. That's when he really set me back.
You want it for drugs, don't you? But you can't have it. Not for that.
Where is it?
If you're hungry, I'll eat some. I'm
not
trying to help.
Where is it?
You're going to have any money.
By that time, I was really strong. I thought I'd
beat that
thing.
Beat that old
thing. I was like, he's the only man between me and the kid high for all time. I didn't get the cover from the Abbott guys were trying to fix him up. And the cops kept trying to get a statement, but he wouldn't give one. They kept talking about how I was a junkie, how they could probably lock me up forever. He would have to do a sign. But he wouldn't. Then he did the strangest thing of all. They were trying to give him a sign, and he just looked at me and said,
"No, she doesn't know what she's doing."
Not like I was crazy or something. But like he forgave me. I really didn't know what I was doing. For once in my life, someone cared the least bit about me. And who was it? A guy had just beaten up. Maybe I could straighten out, get a job, make a living. I don't know. I want to see that guy again. But I know what I'm doing.
All right. These people are ready to be processed. I call your name, line up in front. Collins, Sanderson, Simpson, Grimes, Ballou, Miller, Turner, Jennings, Gibbons, Smith, and Moore. Some of the people have to be in charge of you and me.
What about me?
Take him on. He's not ready for you yet.
Why not?
Another charge is ready.
What other charge? It wasn't signed.
The old man died with you.
Hey, but I'm not in jail. I'm really not in jail very much. They always put me with nice people. But then the police come get me. I never know what it's about. Somebody told me one time that it's wrong to hurt people or to kill people, and that you get put in jail for that. And maybe get killed yourself for doing it. But I didn't hurt anybody or kill anybody, and I told them I didn't. And they kept asking me why I said that. And I said, because it was true. And then the nice police officer would come in and say, "Oh, that's Andy." And I tell him, "I didn't hurt anybody or kill anybody." And he'd say, "I know, Andy. I know." I was glad he was there. I stay in jail for one day, or maybe 2 days, and then they take me to meet some new nice people. I don't know what happened with the nice people I was looking for. Maybe they moved away while I was in jail. I had some special people a long time ago, real special. For some reason, I can't remember why, and they moved away too. Just one day I woke up and they were gone, and I didn't know where. I cried, I think. I stayed there for a long time waiting for them to come back, but they didn't. I got real hungry. I remember that. I started looking for something to eat out behind the place where we lived. And there were a few things. And I found this cat I liked a lot. Then a lady came and talked to me. And I started to meet the nice people, the first ones. They said I couldn't take the cat with me. And I was kind of sad about that. But the people were nice, and I was with them a long, long time, and didn't go to jail or anything. But then one day, I did. And when I got out, I guess they moved. I get kind of scared in jail. People are nice in there sometimes and they do things that make me hurt. And I ask them to stop, but they won't. And I can't make them stop because there's maybe two or three of them. And I'm strong, but I can't stop no two or three of them. And sometimes they have a knife, and I'm scared of it. And what if that policeman isn't there sometimes when they bring me in and I tell them, I didn't hurt anybody or kill anybody, and they don't believe me. They might kill me then. But I'll meet the nice people soon, maybe tomorrow. And they won't move this time, and I won't get in jail again, and I'll go back to where I live, and I'll find that cat, and bring him back with me, and everything will be all right then. Everything will be all right.
Sentenced to 5 years state detention facility. Doe, John, arrest number 772. Remanded to Department of Human Resources, pending further information. Moore, Sam, possession of marijuana. Guilty. Sentenced to 60 days juvenile detention center. Smith, Hank, possession of marijuana. Guilty. Assault with a weapon. Guilty. Tried as an adult. Gibbons, Sean, criminal mischief, vandalism, guilty. 6 months juvenile detention. $15,000 damages payable by parents. Mara, Andrew, Andy, gambling violation, charges dropped. Remanded to Department of Human Resources. Sanderson, Jeffrey, Skip, charges dropped. Accused killed in one vehicle accident while awaiting trial. Two passengers also killed. Miller, Carey, hit and run, guilty. 2 years juvenile detention center, 10 years probation. Grimes, Leah, kidnapping, guilty. Remanded to Department of Human Resources for further psychiatric testing. Below, Ann, theft, shoplifting, guilty. Sentenced to 1 year of weekend work in local retirement home and 2 years probation. Collins, Mark, Sonny. Accessory to aggravated assault and unlawful flight to avoid prosecution. Guilty. 6 months of juvenile detention suspended to 3 years probation. Simpson, Charlotte, Pinky. Delivery of controlled substance. Guilty. Possession of a controlled substance. Guilty. Carrying a prohibited weapon. Guilty. Unlawful flight to avoid prosecution. Guilty. Resisting arrest. Guilty. Tried as an adult. Sentenced to 5 years in state detention facility and 10 years adult probation. Armstrong, Jane. Charges pending. Capital murder. With this abrupt change from childhood to adulthood, decision making can be warped by a mind that has not been allowed to mature. Common things that we all love as children seem to dissolve before the eyes of the delinquent, lost in a dark room of confusion. Swing sets and action figures turn into drugs, alcohol, and guns. Simple schoolyard disagreements turn into stabbings, shootings, and murders. The delinquent does not know how to deal with the problems that lie within themselves. Why do so many children stray away from the positive path in life? After all, when asked, over 90% of students from kindergarten through sixth grade swear they never smoke anything, drink alcohol, or handle a weapon of destruction. Never. Sadly, when many of these children reach adolescence, figure is almost reversed, shattering those innocent promises uttered by small mouths and high-pitched voices. What can be done to prevent another generation of young people from ending up like the characters in Juvie? Well, it all starts with you. Yes, all of you, each and every one of you, you have the capability to stay strong, not giving in to the pressures of a dark, hateful world. Promise yourself today that if nothing else, you will not become another statistic.
Know how this happened. we have to thank a few people and let you guys know who are behind the scenes and all this stuff. Because of these costumes, when they look so good, these characters are going to look so realistic. We have been with our costumes and the right workers' costume. Oh, what space needs pants? Okay, let's go get them. And then Mr. Khan's store also. Thank you. Now, a lot of times the actors get credit, but there's something else that takes place too. The tech group. All this stuff couldn't happen and it wouldn't be as effective if we didn't have the tech group. So the tech group students deserve recognition. Our stage manager, our house manager right here, Chris. Thank you for meeting everybody. Our stage manager told everybody to be home. Keenan Belevins on sound. There's one more student. He not only did lights, he did the video, he wrote the monologue at the end, and he did so. He did the programs also. And he did the flyers, he did the little thing with the pictures on it. That's Mr. Kevin Rose back there. We want to thank you guys so much for your support. I have never seen this many people at a play at Central at nighttime. Thank you guys. This year, we're going to bring you a musical. We're going to do The Wiz. The first time a musical has been done in Central in 10 years. Thank you so much for your donations and everything. God bless you guys. Also, there's one person who's not on the credit. Her name is Tigana. He's not a boss, he's not. Thank you.